Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Roblogs. Today we have Volvo's 7-seater SUV, the XC90, and let's find out if it's as good as the German's 7-seater SUVs, the Audi Q7, the BMW X7, and the Mercedes-Benz GLS. Let's get started. Let's start with the design. So from the front you can notice this is a Volvo because of this grille. It's just the Volvo logo embossed over there, and you have got this front camera over here. Then you have got this black windows, black trim over here which feeds air into the engine. Then you have got this chrome trim surrounding. Then this is your long hood. It's so long, see? And then you have got this hammer headlights, the classic Volvo headlights. This is in all Volvos. And here I got Volvo fully LED active high beam written over here. Then you have got your bumper. So this is the on design car, so it is sporty. That's why you have got this more aggressive front bumper. You have got lots of these vents. Most of them are real, but some of them are fake, like this one over here. Then you have got this nice designs over here, which makes it sporty. The front, it's really like a classic Volvo. It looks really good. Now, let's go to the side. So, coming to the sides, you have got wide wheel arches because this is the art design again, because it makes it sportier. And you have got this 20-inch wheels with some silver and black trim. And you have got Volvo written over here. Then you have got this satin trim over here for the door mirrors. And you have got the blinkers over here. And you have got lots of creases on the side, and yeah, it looks beautiful, and it is really tall car. See, it's taller than me. Then you have got your sky skirts. It is, you have got these sky skirts because as this is the R design, it should look sporty. Then you have got keyless entry, obviously because this is the flagship SUV. Then you have got these roof rails, again, in satin. Then you have got this window surrounding aluminium, which is nice. And you have got your fuel tank over here. And then coming to the back. You have got Volvo open over here. The XC90 badging over here. The T8 badging. The on design. And this is a twin engine. So you might know what this is. It is a hybrid. And it is all wheel drive. And where do you charge the car? Come with me. Here's where you charge the car. See? Then you have got these tail lights, which are classic Volvos. They haven't changed it. Then coming to the bumper, as you know, this is the R design car, so it has got sportier. And you have got these twin exhaust, but it is just a fake surround. You just have one inside. It is kind of real. Not like Audis, because they are utter fake. Same on the opposite side. It is real one. Now,
let's check out the boot.
So you could open the boot like this. Where's the switch? There we go. It's opening. It's electronic. And with all these seats up, you have got 356 liters of boot space. And to fold down the seats, you have to do this before that. You have to fold the headrests. And there we go. And to do the same, it's a bit of a struggle because this is the first time. You have got 1,007 liters of boot space now. And if you fold the third row, which I'm not going to do, to fold down that seat, we will get 1,856 liters of boot space, which is a lot. And to close the boot, I've got this switch over here. And there we go. It's going down. Now, let's check out the third row. So, open the door. The doors are heavy. So now I'm here, and this is the third row, so you have got less space, so the knee room's less, the leg room's tight, but the headroom's good. And yeah, the seats in the back, they are really comfortable. And here got some AC vents over here. See? And here got these cup holders over here. And that's all for the third row. Now, let's go to the middle row. And now I am into the second row. So the leg room's good. Leg room's a lot. And head room's obviously better. And a lot. Then we have got these AC vents over here. Then you have got this massive panoramic sunroof, which you can move back. Then you have got these lights over here. And you have got this coat hook over here. Then you have the two air vents over here. And then you have got this 12 watt socket over here. Then you have got this netting over here for putting some stuff. I got this armrest over here. And if you click this, the cup holders come out. And you have got two cup holders. And then you have the seats. The seats, like in the back, they're really comfortable and even more comfortable than the back, but it's so nice to sit here. Let's now go to the front seats. Let's go inside now. So then you have got this door panel over here. You have got leather everywhere over here. Then you have got this metallic door handle. You have got your memory seat settings over here, which are illuminated if you come close. See? Then you have got these speaker over here. Then you have got this noise aluminium effect and this chrome strip. Then you have got this door bins. They are average size. Then you have got this R design kick plates. And now let me get inside. It's really high. I can see the road really well. Then you have got this air vents over here. Piano black trim. Chrome strip surrounding it. And here you could open the boot again. This is the switch for opening the fuel port. Then you have got the steering wheel. It is wrapped in leather. Then you have got this R design badge over here. Then you have got this piano black surrounding it. And chrome strip also. Then you have got this Volvo badging over here. Your cruise control settings. Paddle shifts. Then you have got your wiper controls over here. Then on this side here, you have got your blinkers and your lights. Your revs. And on that side, you have got your speedometer. Then you have got this huge screen over here, which is massive. And it's like a mini iPad. And you have got lots of stuff like your current position, sat nav, etc. Other stuff like your parking aid, park assist. You have got air suspension to lower the car. And on this side you have got your car status messages. And you have got this. If you have the online You could navigate to Google, Wikipedia, and all. Yeah, it's really good system. Then you got this radios and all that stuff. Then you got your AC vents. You got piano and chrome surrounding all of this. Then coming down, you got this aluminium trim over here. Then over here you got this small storage area. And if you move this, you got your cup holders, the 12-volt socket. And then you got this gear lever, and it is beautiful, and it is in glass. Then this is your start-stop button, or your switch. You turn it like this, so the car becomes on, and see, it's off now. Then you got this drive mode button over here, your parking brake, and auto hold. So overall, the interior is fabulous, and the material quality is also fabulous. It's leather everywhere. Nice. Now let's check out the engine. This is the engine. It's a 2-liter 4-cylinder engine with an electric motor, and combined you have got 400 horsepower and 639 newton meters of torque. It drives by an 8-speed automatic gearbox, and it is all-wheel drive. So that is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and as I told you in the beginning, is it as good as the German 7-seater SUVs? Yes, it is. And I think so. It is way better than all of them. Bye.